Hello everyone, welcome back to online social science class. Today I am going to start history chapter 4, tribals, decus and the vision of a golden age. Before coming to the topic, I will take you back to the previous chapters. If you remember, I have told you that this year's history is a journey of British's entry in India till the end of British rule in India. This is what I have told you, and I am going to repeat this line in all the chapters of history. So do remember this, that we are talking about the British rule in our country. Now you might be thinking, now why this tribals, what the tribals have to do here? The thing is, there was not a single group in our country who was not affected by the British laws, British oppression, the British tyranny. Okay, so all the people, different societies were affected by the British rule, and so were the tribals. So in this chapter, we are going to talk about the tribals, what happened to them, how they were living, and how the British laws brought change in their lives. Okay, so let us move ahead. Now, according to your book and the introduction, what is given in your book, the story starts with the Birsa Munda. Now, who is this person? Birsa Munda, just he belonged to a Munda tribe. That is what is added here. Birsa is a person like he is a rebellion, a person who is coming to protest, who is coming to help people from misery. Okay, so he let us go in detail about Birsa Munda. He born in the family of Mundas. It's a tribe. There are different tribes in our country, and it's one of the tribe, Munda tribe, and that is in Chota Nagpur Plateau. Now, what people believe that he has got some miraculous powers. He has got some magical powers, and he is there to heal us or save us. People were having a strong belief that he is appointed by God to save us. Okay, so people were having a belief, and what happened, if you imagine, if you are in trouble, there is no hope and there is somebody to help you, and that person we treat like a savior, like a God. Similarly, people were following Birsa Munda. They believed that he is the only one who can help them come out of the trouble. He was having thousands of followers, not only his own tribe, but different tribes like Santhals and Orauns, different tribal people were following him. Okay, now I have said that he was appointed to save people from trouble. What the trouble I am talking about? What is this trouble here? If you guess, this trouble is same. The British rule in our country. The Britishers were affecting these tribal people. They were making some strict laws due to which the tribals were very badly, they were affected by this. So they believe that Birsa is going to help them out by this rule. Okay, so this is what we are going to cover in the chapter is, first we will see the problems. What were the problems people were facing? The problems which Birsa is going to sort out. What were the problems which he will set out, which he will resolve? The next thing that you have seen in the title, decus. The word decus is used for the outsiders. Outsiders, any outsider who is troubling you. So they were using the word decus for the Britishers or any outsiders. Now, what was happening to tribal people under the British rule? And what we will see in detail, first we will see what happened with the tribal people, what changes Britishers have brought. So these are the things we are going to cover first. Now, we will move to the tribal societies. Okay, first to know the changes, first of all, we need to know what was there in the tribal societies. Then we will talk about the changes that took place after the British rule. So the tribal societies, if you remember, you have studied in last year also, that they are having their own customs and rituals. They are not following what the settled people are following. Because the Brahmins, they were having their own customs and traditions, and tribal people are having quite different from them. And even what was there, the societies were not having very strict division, very rigid system was not there. Like we were having caste system, a strict division of society was there. But the tribal societies were not having very rigid divisions among themselves. Okay, and they were having a common bond. The same tribe, the people belonging to same tribe were having a very strong relationship. They were not having a division. Okay, but it doesn't mean that they were not having any differences. If I say that they were not having any social and economic differences, it is wrong. Okay, there were differences. They were also performing different activities in their social culture also. There were differences in different tribes that we are going to see further. Okay, so let us see how they were living. Okay, how did the tribal groups live? Tribal groups, they were also performing different activities. As I have told you, there were differences. Economic differences were there. They were performing different activities. So, we are going to see about the different activities they were performing. There were majorly the works, occupations or the activities which they were performing. I have mentioned here, you can see. There were jhum cultivators, there were hunters and gatherers, some were pastoralists, and even some were settled cultivators. So, we are going to talk about all these in detail. We will start with the jhum cultivators, the people who are practicing jhum cultivation, or if I say shifting cultivation, it will be more clear to you, as last year you have studied shifting cultivation. This only is known as jhum cultivation. As the name suggests, what they are doing, they are taking a patch of land in forest area and they are burning the vegetation. And in the same ashes, they are leaving the land so that the soil can get fertile. It gets fertile in the ashes. And then what they are doing? Sowing the seeds. But the word where what I have mentioned here, I have highlighted here is broadcast. What they are doing? They are broadcasting the seeds, not sowing the seeds. Like they are scattering the seeds on the field. Okay, and then that is what the way they are doing cultivation. Once the crop is ready, they are doing cultivation, crop is ready, it is harvested, and then the land is left free. They are not using that land immediately. Once the cultivation is over, harvesting is done, they are leaving that land fallow. Fallow means without any use for several years, almost about 20-30 years, the land is left without using it as fallow. And then what they are doing, they are moving to the different area. So mostly they depend on the movement of free movement within the forest. They move from one place to another practicing shifting cultivation. Mostly these groups are found in northeast and central India who are practicing shifting cultivation. Okay, and they move from one place to another. The next group is hunters and gatherers. As the name suggests, what they are doing? They are hunting animals and they are gathering the forest produce. Okay, so what they do? They are killing the animals, they are using the animal produce, selling the produce, and from forest also they are collecting the different things and selling to different people. Okay, and the one of the group, that is the Khonds, it is one of the tribe of Orissa, they were hunter-gatherers. This is the example who the people who were practicing hunting and gathering. Okay, so they were using the different products of forest and they were selling the things in the local market. But there is a time when they are not getting enough forest produce. So in this condition, they have to wander here and there doing some odd jobs as a labor, carrying the loads, working on the construction sites, different works, different other labor work they were also doing. But there was one group, like here I have mentioned, Begas of central India. This was a tribe who were not ready to become a labor. They were having a pride. See, like we are feeling pride in our area, no? Wherever we are living, we feel proud of our place. Similarly, Begas were having pride that we are the people of forest. We belong to forest and they were not ready to become laborers. Okay, so they were reluctant to do work for others. They were not at all ready to be the laborers and they were having a dignity that we have to work in forest only. Okay, so this was about Begas, and most of the times tribals were doing barter system. They were exchanging the things in turn of things. So what is the one another problem came? Sometimes they were not able to fulfill their needs. They need different products which were not available in their locality. So what they do? They often depend on the different money lenders for fulfilling their needs. And money lenders were taking the advantage. They were giving them loan on very high interest and again forcing them to pay back. So what tribals were facing? They were facing a debt trap. They were facing poverty. They were struggling in this thing. So they considered the money lenders as evil outsiders. As I have told you at the name of the chapter, no, Dikus. Dikus means outsiders. So they were thinking that these money lenders are the cause of our misery. All the problems we are facing because of these money lenders and traders. So this was about hunters and hunter-gatherers. Now, the next group is the pastoralists, who are herding the animals, who are moving with the group of animals. If you have seen while moving in the train, we are seeing, no, people are moving with the cattle, a group of animals. Okay, so they are moving with their cattle in different seasons and fulfilling trading with the different groups. Okay, the examples I have mentioned here are the one Gujjars of Punjab and Labaris of Andhra Pradesh. These are the groups, tribal groups, who are cattle herders. Later on, but what happened, first they were moving freely and selling the things. But there was a time when the Britishers put a ban on animal grazing and all. So they were facing problem, and this was a reason for dissatisfaction among the pastoralists. Okay, so these were the people, pastoralists, who were herding animals. Now, the last one, economic activity, the group which has shown given here is the settled cultivation. Even they were the cultivators. Some of the tribal groups were having a settled life. They started living at one place and doing the cultivation and possessing the land. They started having rights over the land they are living. Okay, one such example is Mundas. They were having the clan rights over the land. Clan here is the whole tribal, their own community, their ancestors. They are working from generations, so they are having a right over the land. The Britishers were having more respect for the settled people. Okay, they thought that these people are more civilized as compared to the people who are moving here and there like hunter-gatherers. So they believe that the settled people are better, and even they were thinking that the people who are roaming here and there like tribals who are doing shifting cultivation, they are wild and savage. They are just uncivilized and they need to be civilized. They want all these tribal people to adopt their culture and become the settled people. This was the British idea, and in the next video we will see how they affected these people as they want change. So we will see how the British laws, their oppressive laws, have affected the tribal groups. In the next video I will tell you, and here I have shown a map where important tribes are located. Just go through it and go through the whole video, prepare your notes. Till then, goodbye. We will start with the Jham cultivators.